Yeah, that's for sure. Roddy's one of the best fighters.
Right hand there by Casimiro. Casimiro! And Rigondeaux's hand is down! The bell and round one, the belt holder, Casimiro. He is in the silver with orange trim, the challenger Rigondeaux.
He threw 60 punches per round in his last fight against Duke Mike, but normally he only averages 39 per round. You see which Casimiro.
Casimiro went so far as to say he'd get him out by the third round. Our first fight.
Watch ahead.
Well, it lasted 10. This is Rigondeaux's fourth fight with trainer Ronnie Shields. Shields said that Rigondeaux, the boxer Ronnie Shields, has ever worked with. That's saying something.
Yeah, that's for sure. Roddy's one of the best fighters.
Right hand there by Casimiro. Casimiro! And Rigondeaux's hand is down.
No knockdown. No knockdown.
Oh, the referee then too, saying it's not a knockdown.
No knockdown.
Oh, Casimiro again on the attack. Rigondeaux trying to hang on. Good start by the belt holder. Casimiro just belted Rigondeaux with another left hand as we go to round two.
So first round, here is where Rigondeaux would hit the canvas. Now, he gets nailed with a left hand that's kind of on the back of the head. And that, whether that would be knocked down, who knows? But he was hit several times while on the mat, which, of course, could have also created a point deduction or
difficult coming in.
And Casimiro unloading that right uppercut. Oh, there's a sniper-like straight left hand down the middle.
He is always
competing in right now. Time will tell. And boy, another beautifully added and a half gone here in the second. Counter right upstairs by Rigondeaux.
This is, look at the tempo right now. It's really calm. It's what Rigondeaux wants it now.
And Rigondeaux's having
outside. He's waiting for the right time.
Oh, beautiful lead left hook to the liver by Casimiro.
Was able to get him with some right hands.
Yeah, Casimiro, the fourth Filipino fighter to win titles in three weight classes. As he's testing for Casimiro is that he's carried his punching power with him as he.
And here's what Casimiro is not doing at all. He is not cutting off the ring at all against
Pan Am Games. I was 17 years old. The man was close to his 30s. But I mean, same thing, same scenario. He was moving off three rounds. So Casimiro has 12 rounds.
Tough one. Rigondeaux himself has only thrown 61.
And I think it's about being patient now for Casimiro. You got to wait for the right time to let go of the right hand, which he still hasn't.
Yeah.
And Casimiro attempting to make that investment to the body, as you've mentioned as well, but off balance throwing that left hand. But the investment to the body will be one way if you can tag him, Abner, to slow him down. Oh, and Rigondeaux comes back. Lead left hand by Rigondeaux. 1.5 left here in the fourth. Casimiro trying to find a way to close the distance without being counted right to the point, Alan. I have to agree with his sentiments in the.
You see him trying to counterpunch more early in the round.
Yeah, I think even as a trainer, you get frustrated. You know, you worked on something and it wasn't just running, sit in the center of the ring. Throw more punches.
And, you know, a couple of those rounds, the left hands,
job of in terms of trying to cut off the ring.
Well, exactly that. Do not just follow Rigondeaux. You got to close the ring. Do that. Work. Yeah. He's done it a few times.
Well, Rigondeaux with a side headlock.
There it is. That's a good body shot.
And for Rigondeaux, you know,
there's an uppercut and another right hand. Another right hand by
13 punches. So, you know, it's going to be just tough for them to give him the round.
A lot of pot shotting, and there was another left hand by Rigondeaux. There's a body shot by Casimiro. But shot singular, not plural. Many believe. not a factor. He's got lots of it.
That's for sure. Now, here's where Casimiro did a good job of kind of holding the left hand. Of,
if he could get, he did ask for that. He told Rigondeaux, hey, make sure you just get in the center of the ring.
He called, he called Central Casting. They sent him the wrong Rigondeaux.
Well, Rigondeaux again with the left. There's a left that just bounced off the top of Rigondeaux's head, but Casimiro, and the pressure has abated a bit as well, although now going to the body with the right hand. Doing, in fact, has talked about his influences.
Yeah, but those fighters were really well defensively, but offensively also. They'll come back with great punches.
Yeah, Rigondeaux has certainly not been active in this fight.
I think that this is what frustrates the fans and people. Yeah, I mean, if he was defensive, you know, counter punches just like that, one, two punches, clean punches, okay, I'll be happy with that. But if he just make...
Look at here. This is a stationary Rigondeaux, and it's up to Casimiro to make it work right there.
Of the sixth, nearing the midway point of this championship match.
In this round.
There's a counter left by.
That he deserves because he's the aggressor, but he has to land punches.
Nullifying Casimiro's attack, but Casimiro cannot just allow Rigondeaux to continue to chew up the ring.
Casimiro has thrown 20 punches more than Rigondeaux, so he hasn't been. And there's Casimiro kind of telling Rigondeaux, come on, let's fight. It's intriguing to me that we've had almost seven rounds. I believe he wasn't capable of even moving like this for seven rounds. Whether good or bad, whether you like it or don't like it, he seems capable of doing it, which is shocking at age 40.
Rigondeaux's doing the movement that he wants.
Yeah, exactly.
And I said this, you know, in the beginning of the fight, Casimiro's going to be missing a lot. He can't, he cannot get frustrated.
Oh, he's getting frustrated.
Be patient.
As are the fans getting frustrated.
Yeah. And he's reacting even to feints by Rigondeaux, which is fascinating.
10 seconds,
10 seconds. Help his cause.
Well, the weather, a lot hotter than the action thus far. 70 degrees.
Get discouraged. No, you got to throw 3-4 punches in a row. So it's up to let him Rigondeaux leave. Okay, you missed there. You let go of the
right hand. Well, good news here for record pass round 7, Al. The amount of knockouts that Casimiro's been able to record.
He brings his... I think most boxing fans are surprised that Rigondeaux has been able to fight. Oh, there's that counter left hand.
Counter left hand by Rigondeaux.
He wants to get extraordinary. And that, now there's that, he has had moments with it. And here he does land it kind of on the throat of Casimiro, but it's a landed punch. And then later on, Casimiro doing what we said, you know, doubling, throwing the left hook. That keeps Rigondeaux a little bit more in place and at least gave him an opportunity to
play. Abner, just give us your assessment of what you're seeing and educate us. Oh, there's Rigondeaux on Casimiro. Help us understand.
His fight, period, you know, which is use the entire ring, wait for Casimiro to make mistakes. Combination, at least you're getting one of them is going to touch.
And there's one that did touch, the left hand, the right, and now Casimiro attempting to put pressure on Rigondeaux.
Just that is what Casimiro has to do. That's what he did in an older fighter out. There it is, you keep following him. Make it an uncomfortable fight for Rigondeaux.
Rigondeaux coming with that left hand downstairs, but again, the left hand is much during this amount of the fight. And when he does stand stationary, he's still fainting. And Rigondeaux, how do you choose what you think? There's a nice left hook by Casimiro. More aggressive. And the important part there was he used the jab to, as a range finder. Then he landed the right, and then he got a left hand in. And later on in the round, in what might have been a round that Casimiro could, you could make a strong case for him winning, he goes to the body with the right hand. and no counterpunch. Well, there's Rigondeaux landing his own counterpunch to the body. So, yeah.
And here Casimiro explodes forward, going to the body. There's the left hand by Rigondeaux, and here we've seen an exchange for the first time in a long time to the current belt holder.
Yeah, and there was an uptick for Casimiro. Now there's two nice jabs from Rigondeaux, but he won't stand there and try and, you know. And you can look at this fight. One of the things is the lack of jab. It might not be thrilling to people, but he's been able to do it.
And now Casimiro tries to go in. Boy, now Rigondeaux right after.
Of course he did.
Oh, nice left hand that lands for Rigondeaux.
We're trying to make some things happen, and going downstairs, he has landed that that right hand from time to time and came with a left hand following it. And the action is sporadic, so you can pick out these spots and see where something happened. And there, the left hook that semi-landed, and that was a part where Rigondeaux really frustrated.
He's doing a great training, and to see him just...
Nice left hook by Rigondeaux.
Trying to find Burrow his way inside. John Real Casimiro defending his 118-pound belt against the 40-year-old.
Your one hand, the amount of combinations thrown in this fight.
Ronnie Shields has to say, we'd like to get his thoughts on.
No, and they have combined for less than 500, right around 500 punches. Combined for 500 punches. So, you know, there's not a lot going on. Surprising. I thought we might see some boxing from Rigondeaux. I didn't expect to see it.
Casimiro tries to put a combination. Good luck to the three judges seated at ringside. It will be up to them to determine who leaves Dignity Health Sports Park a 118-pound champion.
And still.